How are you doing now?
I've stabilized a little bit. I think the first couple of days were just excruciating. They just ripped me apart. And then, you know, we had several weeks of misleads and misinformation that constantly changed. But in this last week, I think I've come to a realization that that for sure the flight is still intact and the passengers are still alive, because the sequence of information that we've been given actually all points to that. And that was the common theme at the meeting with the families. I believe all the other families feel the same way that I do.
When you say they're covering something up, why do you think they would do that?
I think they're doing that to hide what's really happened to the plane. Now, whether that's purely a Malaysian activity or if other countries are involved, I don't know. I mean, I really don't know why or how they've pulled it off. But I refuse to believe that the Malaysian military ignored a 777 in their airspace. There was one of the family members, a young gentleman, who pushed forward an idea that he had had notice from people he knew that the jet had actually been accompanied by fighter planes for some period of time, and there was some witness to that. Now, that's the first time I'd ever heard of that prior to this meeting, but that actually makes a lot more sense than a flight being ignored by the military. So I think we need to have better view into where that plane ultimately went and who's got it now.
And Sarah, you know, you've spent so much time, and obviously I know, you know, you're very emotional about it, but you're also very analytical going through this. And you really have come to the conclusion, you do believe it is intact, that somebody has custody or control of it right now.
Yeah, I mean, my heart tells me that Philip is still alive. I feel his presence still. I feel confident that he is still connected to me in reality, not just in spirit. And logically, it's the only thing that makes sense. And again, sometimes you just have to look at that one little nugget, and maybe all of the run-up to it or the follow-on from it don't make any sense yet. But I'm sure that the military in Malaysia knew that plane was there and has tracked it in some way. Now, whether they were in control of it or not, right, I don't know. You know, it could have been... Many people say it might be the United States that's involved. A lot of people are pointing their fingers at the Chinese. The Russians have been raised. But the general thinking across the families here, and even non-families, so people I've had a chance to meet with that are local Malays with some connections to the military and or security, they all believe this is actually a military operation of some sort.